Should mind my step.
Go ahead.
I'm listening.
Think of it as tribute. The kind a king might pay to a more powerful neighbor to avoid invasion. As long as I pay, there will be peace. But should I ever stop, along comes a war. I can assure you, the battlefield would extend well beyond the borders of my body alone. An eruption the size of Waterdeep, I think my exact words were.
My favorite traveling companion. It's simple. Just find a vampire that will drink your blood and turn you into a vampire spawn. Their obedient puppet. In theory, the next step is to drink their blood. Once you've done that, you're free. And a true vampire. Yes and no. The problem is, once you're a vampire spawn, they completely control you. They have to allow you to bite them. And why would they do that? Vampires are power-hungry creatures. They won't lose a servant to create a competitor. Trust me, it doesn't happen. I've already apologized. What more do you want? Unless you're looking for another nibble. No innocence. You have my word. Only villains that we need to kill anyway. After all, you know what I am now. I can fight with all my weapons, teeth included. And if I happen to drain the occasional bandit during a fight, what's the harm? They're just as dead. As am I. I'm starting to feel a little peckish already.
Almost pleasant traveling with company. If you ignore all the less pleasant aspects. Fine. What's on your mind? I suppose some would commend our actions. Goblins would have razed that whole place to nothing if it weren't for us. No excuse to rest on our laurels, though. We've still got our own problems to contend with. I don't think I've ever had a confidant quite like you. And if I have, I can't remember them. On one hand, they seem useful. But on the other hand, or perhaps tentacle before long, we know where they're coming from and what lies at the end of that path. I never expected seramorphosis to be tempting. I think we should resist these powers. There's simply too many unknowns for us to risk it. It's been known to happen.
Thank you.
You are as thick as they come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Get out! Has that Riddler eaten your brain already? Leave, or you'll end up in tonight's stew. We'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's already marinating.
Closer to the mirror, a pale face appears, contorted in fear. Fists slam against the mirror's surface again and again.
My sweet Callum, whose beloved asked that his beauty never fade.
What is this?
My darling Macron, she wished for the mind of a genius. But that silly head crushed me.
Stop. Please. Please.
This poor dear wished never to lay eyes on her family again. My dearest Efren, he begged me to halt the deadly disease that ravaged him. My gentle Lauren. He wished to know what was to come.
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through, not again. Images flash. A man cowering, a bag open at his feet. Gold coins spilling onto the floor. His cries for mercy are cut short as the hag slices into him, dismembering him painstakingly, limb by limb. She cackles, the man's remaining flesh twisted and contorted, becoming the twisted surface of the door before you. Flee, you feel it cry. A scene appears in your mind. Two paladins and a cleric marching through the door, shrouded in the glow of the divine. Weapons brandished, they charge into the hag's lair. Screams of terror pierce the air.
You let them in? Naughty. That's a decade for each. You're mine for 30 more years, Petal.
The door stays silent. Fear rushes through you as the door shakes, remembering the hag's smile. It remains firmly closed as the presence huddles within.
Don't look.
Let's have a look at my
son. Don't! No. No! Don't look. Mustn't look. Mustn't see. I see it. I see what's to come. Me. Dead. Dead! Flesh rotten, bone shining! Skull splitting, knife twisting, gut spilling! All future. All bad. All gods, don't hurt me. Oh, please, 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 please. Monster. Monster! For mind dripping, flesh peeling, mind flayer! No! No! Mind flayer! Get away! Get away!
No intention of letting that happen.
Stop! Please!
Feel the barest hint of life from within the door.
Stop. Please. Please.
Wait. Wait. Hello, Petal. My, my. The mask suits you. Just relax. See the world with fresh eyes. And let your dear old Aunt Ethel look after you.
Away! Don't look. Don't!
Oh, I have the magic touch.
Careful. Very, very quiet.
Assume nothing.
deep and move.
Auntie, be kind to our guests.
Let's have some cup.
Victory awaits. My path be true.
Someone's left a trap out for us.
Let's move.
A trap. Someone doesn't like visitors.
Proceeding. Indolence breeds madness.
What now?
Let me work my magic.
shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Moving in. Let's get going. Breathe deep and move. Ready and willing. Looking ahead. Yes? Seek and you shall find me. Direct me.
You have my attention. Certainly.
Have a lot on my mind. In it. My fortune!
Trap. Be cautious. Keep a blade close.
One true way.
Oh.
considerate.
No time to rest.
Day, yes. For now.
Eager for battle.
Still alive. So that's progress. Light on my feet.
There, in the cage.
You come to my home, interfere in my business, and now have the gall to face me in the heart of my lair! You petulant bollocks! I'll rip your spine out your asshole! I'll use your blood to spice my stew! I'll keep you alive until I've sucked the marrow from your bones! Then I'll bring you back and do it all over again.
Just get out of here, please.
You want the girl so bad.
Outmaneuver them.
Pawn to cleric 4.
I present. Make way.
Here.
to keep going.
Are you lost? Maybe your soul.
Allow me to demonstrate. Indubitably.
I'm ready.
Wait! Oh! Wait just a tick! Killing me is a waste of time. I'll find a way to return. Always have, always will. But it's unpleasant. So how about we be civilized about this, I have something you want. She's worthless to you. Let me leave with the girl, and I'll give you power. You want to be stronger, tougher, smarter? Done. Anything is possible. Just let me keep the girl and her babe.
Not only would this be a vile deal, it would be folly to trust a hag's gifts.
It's your choice, sweetness. Not a hope. It's one or the other. Gods, turn your goody soul to shite.
But the deal. What about my husband? What happens to him?
Deal's off, you dumb cow. And you've him to thank for it. Not that it matters. I'll find another just as plump and ripe. I can set up shop elsewhere. People always need lotions and potions. If I ever see you again, you'll have a tentacle for a tongue. Bye-bye, petal.
You bastard! You ruined it! You ruined everything! Ethel was going to bring my husband back. Back from the dead. And now I'll never see him again. Because of you! This... just a bit longer and my child would have been born. And all this would have been over. Don't judge me. I have nothing. My baby would have been raised in rags. Auntie Ethel promised to give this child a good life. Teach them magic, even. More than I could have done. I always wanted to be a mother. I just never thought I'd do it alone. Now I'll have to drag Connor's coffin all the way home. It's the only way this child will ever meet their father.
hope you're happy.
Elminster's not around, so might as well.
Yes.
Surprise. Caution is warranted here.
How delicious. Traps. How considerate. Subtle steps. A trap.
Someone doesn't like visitors.
Be careful. There are traps about.
Didn't hear you coming. I know I should head home, but I can't bring myself to leave. The thought of putting him in a wheelbarrow and making the journey all over again. Please. Connor used to say only a fool turned down the divine. I miss him. Every moment of every day. God damn it. I can't believe it didn't work. That all of this was for nothing.
From the wand, the air suddenly tastes acrid. It wants to be used.
Bring it back! Bring Connor back! Please!
Something pull at you. The creature yearns for a master.
What have you done to him? He's not a creature. He's my husband. I wanted him back, the way he was, not this. Connor? Connor! I don't even know if he's in there, but he might be. And if he is, I'll find him and bring him back. Thanks. But we'll need more than luck. A bloody miracle, more like it. I'll find a wizard or something. Maybe someone in Baldur's Gate can help us. Connor always said you can find anything in that city. Remember? And thank you, I guess. Come on, love. Let's go.
Using Ethel's wand wasn't the best idea.
What happened, happened. Standing here arguing won't change it.
entire village if seen it properly. Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? I do enjoy a good bargain, if anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well. I have mushrooms to...
A vessel wobbles on the lake's murky...